إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهديه الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما ثم أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله جل وعلا وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وإن شر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أجارني الله وإياكم من النار ثم أما بعد. All praise and thanks belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and may the peace and blessing of Allah be upon His servant and final messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As to all follows, my dear respected brothers in Islam, today's khutbah is a message and a sincere advice to many Muslims that commit a crime that is just as bad as secularism. You know, my brothers in Islam, secularism is a very bad deed in which the people, they want to separate between the country and the state's affairs from religious affairs. So religion is one thing and the worldly affairs and our day-to-day affairs is a totally other thing. And with this same attitude and mentality, there are many Muslims that separate a deen, they separate the religion from manners and good character. This is a crime that we want to speak about today, bad manners in Islam. People that separate religion from good character and good manners and good dealings. This is just as bad as a sin as secularism. My brothers in Islam, many people embraced Islam because of the manners of Muslims. And many people decided to remain upon their kufr. And many decided to leave Islam altogether because of manners of some Muslims. Well, subhanallah, yani today what we want to go through is the Quran very quickly. We want to go through the Quran from beginning to end very quickly to see what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions of character and manners in the Quran and how to deal with others and morals and etiquettes. My brothers in Islam, ad-deen, the religion, is not just ibadat, it's not just worship. Prayer and fasting or hajj or sadaqat, that's not only what the deen is. The deen is also mu'amalat, dealings with others and good manners and behaving towards others and upholding the rights of others. Your manners can either end you up in Jahannam, as we'll see with the ayat and ahadith, or your manners could either end you up in Jannatul Firdaus, as we'll also see in these ahadith and ayat. My brothers in Islam, many Muslims, they display a total different personality when he's involved in business dealings, with business issues. When there's money involved, he's a different person. When he's involved in a divorce, he's a different person. When he's involved at court with another Muslim, he's a different person. And he's not the same person that you know in the masjid. He's not the same person that reads the Quran and he cries. He's not the same person you know in Ramadan. And he's not that same person that is concerned in fasting Mondays and Thursdays. He becomes a totally different person altogether. You will have never imagined that one day he'll ever become like this. Bad manners made him like this. And this is a serious crime. Let's look at the first ayah. Like we'll begin with Surah Al-Baqarah, and this ayah is enough to terrify us from bad manners and what it'll do and its consequences in your deen and in your own life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تُبْطِلُوا صَدَقَاتِكُمْ بِالْمَنِّ وَالْأَذَىٰ O you who believe, do not destroy, do not invalidate your sadaqat. A sadaqat is a worship. How are you going to invalidate it? How would you destroy your sadaqat? Bil manni wal adha, with bad manners. Al man wal adha is when you speak and when you keep speaking, reminding the person you gave him a favor of the favor you did to him, so that he feels bad about himself, or so that he feels like he owes you something. Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying, La tubtilu sadaqatikum. Your sadaqah, your deen, your worship is batil. It's cancelled, it's nullified, it's invalid, it's destroyed with bad manners that you will have. With bad manners, لا تبطلوا صدقاتكم بالمن والأذى. Allah Azza wa Jalla is warning us in this ayah, bad manners will destroy your worship. Don't be deceived and don't be fooled by your worship. If your manners are neglected, if the dealings with others, if your responsibility at work, if your financial dealing with others, if you're yani dealing with your family, with your wife, with your children is terrible, don't be deceived and fooled with your good deed. لا تبطلوا صدقاتكم بالمن والأذى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, at the end of the ayah, he said, والله لا يهدي القوم الكافرين. He began the ayah with آمنوا, he ended it with كافرين. Such a person on the day of judgment loses all his good deeds because of bad manners that he had towards the people. Subhanallah. For yani my brothers in Islam, Many times we discuss worship and we speak about worship, والصلاة والصوم والزكاة. However, manners is hardly discussed, and manners is just as important as worship. Rather, it's an integral form and part of worship. As some of the Salaf rahimahumullah, they would say, لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ أَسَاسٍ وَأَسَاسُ الْإِسْلَامِ حُسْنُ الْخُلُقِ. That everything has a foundation, and the foundation of Islam is good character and good manners. Without this foundation, your Islam is not built and your Iman cannot build up. My brothers in Islam, the first surah that was revealed to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Al-Madinah, yani after his hijrah, the first word that Jibreel alayhi salam revealed from seven heavens and came down and gave it to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as soon as he entered Al-Madinah was Waylul lil mutaffifin. Surah Al-Mutaffifin was the first surah to come to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as he entered Al-Madinah. Waylul lil mutaffifin. May the destruction, woe to al-mutaffifin. May the destruction be upon al-mutaffifin. Who are al-mutaffifin? The one who has two personalities. When it comes to his rights, he wants everyone to respect him and everyone to fulfill his rights. And when it comes to the rights of others, yukhsirun, he violates the rights of others. When it comes to him, he wants the discount that he wants. He wants everything to be easy for him and all rights fulfilled and give it to him. But when it comes to others, he'll overcharge them for a service he cannot even do and he cannot even deliver. هذا المطفف ويل للمطففين. The first ayah that came down is speaking about people that shortchange the people in business, that steal the people in business, that promise a service they cannot even live to. ويل للمطففين. إخوانا في الله, يعني the first ayah that was expected to come down in Al-Madinah was something about الصلاة, الخشوع في الصلاة. Rather, that wasn't the first ayah. The first ayah was about manners and dealings, our behavior with each other. That was the first ayah. And this, if anything, it teaches us the value and importance of manners in Islam. Yani, if you have cut up and you have torn the premats from your hours and hours of salat, but still you have cut and you've torn your relationship with your relatives and you had severed these ties and you're disrespectful to your parents and you cheat and you lie and you keep promising the people and you go against your word and you cannot deliver and you demand a discount for whenever work is done for you and you consume a riba and you backbite. If this is you, then Allah is saying, وَيْلٌ لِلْمُطَفِّفِينَ. Woe to you, may the destruction befall someone like this. My brothers in Islam, this ayah was revealed to companions. Then it's a Madani surah. It's not a Meccan surah. It wasn't revealed to the likes of Abu Lahab and Abu Jahl. This ayah came down among Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali, Talha radiallahu anhum. It came among these people and this ayah was revealed to them. These are people just like us that said, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. It was revealed to people that prayed behind Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in al-Masjid al-Nabawi, as though Allah azza wa jalla is saying, worship without manners is non-beneficial for the person. Just like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَوَيْلٌ لِلْمُصَلِّينَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ صَلَاتِهِمْ سَاهُونَ Just as Allah Azza wa Jal cursed those who neglect their salat, in the same manner, He cursed those who do not have any manners. وَيْلٌ لِكُلِّ هُمَزَةٍ لُمَزَةٍ Someone with bad manners goes around and he backbites and he gossips and he slanders the people. وَيْلٌ لِلْمُطَفِّفِينَ Also in his dealings, his terrible rubbish with the people. وَيْلٌ For the one who leaves at the worship. وَيْلٌ Also for the one who leaves out the manners. My brothers in Islam, topic is serious and it requires a lot of attention day after day. The one who performs al-hajj and cheats, unacceptable image in Islam. The one who prays and then he brings music and dances to his daughter's wedding, unacceptable in Islam. The one who has a beard but still attends the club and he drinks the alcohol and does the drugs and whatever it is, unacceptable image in Islam. These examples, such people, they destroy the image of Islam. Instead of you being an asset and an addition to Islam, you became a loss to Islam. Wal'iyadhu billah, my brothers in Islam, these are very important topics, the manners in Islam and what bad manners would do to such people. This is the first surah that came down in Medina. وَيْلٌ لِلْمُطَفِّفِينَ طيب, the first hadith that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spoke of in Al-Madina. Abdullah bin Salam radiallahu anhu, he narrates. He said the day that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam entered Al-Madina and he was walking among the people, the first thing he said, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ أَفْشُ السَّلَامِ O people, spread as-salam, spread the peace. What's that? Worship or manners? Manners. Have good manners. Second thing, وَأَطْعِمُ الطَّعَامِ Feed the people. Look after the needy and the poor. What's that? That is manners. وَصِلُوا الْأَرْحَامِ And keep ties with your relatives. Maintain those bonds. What's that? Manners. At the end, وَصَلُّوا بِاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّاسُ نِيَامِ And pray at night while the people are sleeping. تَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةَ بِسَلَامِ You'll enter the paradise peacefully. Three quarters of the road to paradise is manners. This is the first thing that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam began his speech upon entering Al-Madinah. First, three manners was something to do with manners and dealing with others. And at the end, the worship was mentioned. Why? Because this is what righteousness is. Righteousness is good character and good manners. Allah azza wa jal, He proved the truthfulness and authenticity of Islam. Allah proved the authenticity of Islam through the character of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In Surah Al-Qalam, Allah Azza wa Jal, He said, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ You're upon great character and manners. This section, this ayah alone was enough to prove the authenticity and truthfulness of Islam. In the same surah, Surah Al-Qalam, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to keep away from certain people, who are these people that he's supposed to keep away from? فَلَا تُطِعِ الْمُكَذِّبِينَ Don't follow and don't be deceived. Al-mukathibin, the liars, the compulsive liars, that's bad manners. And then in the ayat, وَلَا تُطِعْ كُلَّ حَلَّافْ مَهِينَ And do not follow the one who Hallaf, he continues to swear. He swears a lot. He takes a lot of oaths. And it's worthless for him. He doesn't even realize what he's saying. Don't follow such a person. Keep away from such a person. That is also bad manners. Hamaz, Masha'im bin Amim. The one who ridicules and mocks and slanders and backbites. Don't follow him either. Bad manners. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, Manna'il lil khair. The one who prevents the good from the people, bad manners, don't follow him. Mu'tadin, transgressor, athim, sinful oppressor, do not follow these people. For in the same surah, Allah Azza wa Jal teaches us that what will prove to you the truthfulness of Islam is the character of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the worst threat to Islam is the bad character. This is why Allah Azza wa Jal tells him, do not follow 1, 2, 3, 4. All of them had bad characters. My brothers in Islam, Surah Al-A'raf. If you look into Surah Al-A'raf, once we gave a khutbah about who the people of Al-A'raf are. But there is an opinion among the ulama, rahimahumullah, that they mention that the people of Al-A'raf are those who performed al-jihad fi sabilillah, but they were disrespectful to their parents. So they ended up on a mountain of Al-A'raf. Shuf, subhanallah, such a huge deed, al-jihad fi sabilillah. But they failed in their manners and dealings with their parents. As a result, they got trapped on a mountain. Allahu a'lam, where their ending will be. Fa al-jihad, it was leading them to Jannatul Firdaus. It was leading them to that. However, their bad manners forced them to stand on a mountain between the paradise and the hellfire. They are awaiting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy to descend upon them, and then eventually they would enter the paradise. But yani, my brothers in Islam, you see, this Al-A'raf, the people of Al-A'raf, this is a loss, but it is nowhere near, and it is not compared to what is about to come and still to be discussed. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he informs us that a woman, she showed bad manners and displayed bad manners to a cat. And as a result, that led her to Jahannam, wal-iyadhu billah. For imagine the one who shows bad manners to other human beings, to his parents, to his relatives, to his Muslim brothers and sisters, to the scholars of Islam, to the religious and the knowledgeable of Islam. Imagine what his ending would be. And the same manner, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he teaches us that a woman, a prostitute, yani she earns her money through zina, she displayed and showed good character and manners to a dog that was thirsty, and she gave him some water to drink. Allah Azza wa Jalla appreciated her deed. He forgave her and he admitted her into the paradise. All of this because bad manners and good manners. Good manners ended her up in the paradise. Bad manners with the cat ended the other one in Jahannam, wal-iyadhu billah. My brothers in Islam, the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that we discussed here weeks ago about the three from Bani Israel that were trapped in a cave. The cave closed up, three in a cave, khalas, dead, that's it, they're finished. No contact to the outside world, no one knows where they are. What are they going to do? They begin to make a dua. The first one, he says, oh Allah, I was good to my parents. What's that? Manners or worship? Manners. The second one, oh Allah, there was a cousin that I loved and I was almost about to fall into zina with her. So I retrieved and I gave her a sadaqah. What is that? Manners or worship? Manners. The third person, oh Allah, I was responsible and honest in my job and I gave to the last cent and to the last dollar what I owe for my employer and for my worker, and I gave him that. That is his dua. What's that? Manners or worship? That was manners. All three of them displayed good manners. As a result, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removes the boulder and they walk out free. For this reason, yani subhanallah, Allah azza wa jal relieved them from their difficulties and from their calamities because of their good manners. And for this reason, maybe the difficulties and calamities in your life are because of your bad manners, because of your bad dealings with your workers, because of your bad dealings with your friends, with your wife, with your children, with your Muslim brothers and sisters. Al-Shaykh Sha'rawi rahimahullah, he narrates a story under one of the ayat in his tafsir. He narrates a story that happened to him. And he said, one day I employed a teacher to teach at my college. So this teacher, he began to complain to Al-Shaykh Sha'rawi and to the people that were in the school. He's complaining that the wages are low, life is tough, and yani, I'm barely getting any money, going through a lot of difficulty to go from one week to another week in my life. So Sha'rawi rahimahullah, he said, one day I saw this man. I saw him carrying papers and pencils and pens and sharpeners, school stationery. He carried them and they belong to the office, they don't belong to him. And he took them and he's walking out with them. For Sheikh rahimahullah, he said to him, what are you doing? He said to him, well, I don't have money. I cannot buy school stationery for my children. So I take from the office and I go, what am I going to do? For Sheikh, he said to him, هَذَا مَالٌ حَرَامٌ. This is haram money. He said to him, what am I going to do? What's the solution? For Sheikh rahimahullah, he said to him, it's because of this haram money that you face these difficulties and calamities in your life. So after a while, this man woke up to himself and he repented. Wallah subhanahu wa ta'ala removed his difficulties and worries from his life. Al-Shaykh al-Sha'rawi, under the story, he says, subhanallah, this person, he did this sin and he did not even take notice of it. This type of bad manners and corrupt character was the reason for his calamities and difficulties in life. So when he made a tawbah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala relieved him from all his problems. Most of our problems in life are because of our bad manners, but we don't realize it because bad manners became a day-to-day thing with us, something that becomes normal. So difficulties in your life, perhaps it's not because of the haram you saw. It is perhaps because of the bad deeds and the bad dealings and the bad character that one carries. My brothers in Islam, in Surah An-Nahl, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ وَإِيْتَاءِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى وَيَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ وَالْبَغِي يَعِظُكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, he said that this is an ayah that contained and mentioned all good in Islam. And this ayah is an ayah that mentioned all bad in Islam. It commanded us of all good and it forbid us from all evil. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ. Allah commands justice, وَالْإِحْسَانِ and excellence, وَإِتَاءِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى and giving the relatives, giving him their rights, وَيَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ and Allah Azza wa Jal, He prevents and forbids you from al-fahshaa, immorality, وَالْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ وَالْبَغِي, al-munkar, transgression, al-baghi, oppression. Uthman ibn Mad'un radiallahu anhu, he says, مَسْتَقَرَّ الْإِيمَانُ فِي قَلْبِي مَسْتَقَرَّ الْيَقِينُ فِي قَلْبِي حَتَّى نَزَلَ قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ. Allahu Akbar. Uthman ibn Mad'un radiallahu anhu was a man that loved good character and he loved justice, and he said Islam and certainty in Islam did not settle and solidify in my heart until Allah revealed this ayah. Then he loved good manners and he says, wallah, there's a deen that advocates for good manners and it calls against bad manners. This is the deen. And he chose it and he accepted it. And Islam and certainty settled in his heart because of this ayah. Uday ibn Hatim al-Ta'i radiallahu anhu, he was a king from among the kings of the Arabs. And he accepted Islam because of good manners. Adi radiallahu anhu, very interesting story he has. He said that he came to Al-Madinah, right? He came from his town to Al-Madinah to investigate the authenticity of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he came and he's wearing a big cross, act to provoke the Muslims and to provoke the Sahaba. And he walks into Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he invites him to walk with him down the streets of Al-Madinah. You know, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his companions are walking in front of him, some behind, on the left, on the right. When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is walking, Adi radiallahu anhu is with him. So they're walking together. And there's a young slave girl. She waves down Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the companions, they stop. When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he goes to her and he attends to her. And she begins to complain, "Ya Rasulullah, my master is overworking me and too much and oppressing me." For Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went and he solved her issue. Wa Adi radiallahu anhu is waiting. For he says, "Wallah, ma hadhihi akhlaqul muluk." No way, this cannot be the manners of kings. Kings don't do like this. Kings ignore and just keep walking. He says, إِنَّهُ لَرَسُولُ اللَّهِ. He must be a messenger of Allah. He broke the cross that is around his neck and he accepted Islam because of the good character of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My brothers in Islam, An-Najashi rahimahullah, he also accepted Islam because of the da'wah of Ja'far ibn Abi Talib when he taught him of the good manners that Islam preaches. Qaisar, the Roman Empire, when he heard the good manners of Islam from Abu Sufyan radiallahu anhu, he said, "If I was with your prophet right now, I would wash his foot." Kings accepted Islam because of the good manners of the Muslims. Now, let's ask the question. Don't ask yourself the question, how many accepted Islam and embraced Islam because of our good manners? Rather, let's ask the question and be serious. How many people left Islam? And how many people neglected al-masjid? Or how many people left their salat? And how many people don't want to associate with the Muslim community because of our bad manners? Ask that the question. And how many people refuse and want to remain kuffar because of the bad manners of the Muslims? My brothers in Islam, serious deal. And this is a serious topic that we're supposed to speak about. On the Day of Judgment, there is a hadith that mentions that the people have come out of their grave. Resurrection has finished. As-sirat, al-mizan, al-ardu ala Allah. The major events of the Day of Judgment. Finally, at last, they're over. And the believers, they cross as-sirat. Khalas, Jahannam is behind. And the paradise is in front. It's only a few steps and we enter. All of a sudden, stop. Well, hadith mentions, Allah Azza wa Jalla, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, يَخْلُصُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ مِنَ النَّارِ فَيُحْبَسُونَ عَلَى الْقَنْطَرَةِ. Allahu Akbar, that the people are caged and trapped and they're not allowed to enter the paradise. They have stopped right between the paradise and the hellfire. All of a sudden, there's one more event that we still haven't finished. It is known as Al-Qantara. Al-Qantara is a place in where now the judgment of your manners is going to happen. The dealing between others, now it's going to be judged. You oppressed others, you shortchanged others, you displayed bad character to others, now it's going to be judged. Before that, it was only your worship that is judged. Now, the dealings between others. And in this same hadith, subhanAllah, yani my brothers in Islam, Allah Azza wa Jal, He chose an interesting place for this type of judgment. In front of you, the paradise. Behind you is Jahannam. Bayn al-jannati wal-nar, the hadith. In other words, your manners. Your manners might be the one that would push you into the paradise. Or your manners would be the one that would retract you back into Jahannam. Wal-iyadhu billah. It is this moment in which the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once, he asked his companions, أَتَدْرُونَ مَنِ الْمُفْلِسِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ? Do you know who the bankrupt is on the day of judgment? This is the moment it'll happen. Who's the bankrupt? For they said, Ya Rasulullah, al-muflis, the one that's bankrupt is the one that has no cent and no dollar. For he said to them, don't worry about this. This is muflis of the dunya. The muflis, the bankrupt of the hereafter. مَنْ يَأْتِي بِصَلَاتِ? He comes with salat. Shuf, the word salat has a tanween at the end. يعني النكرة للتعظيم. Salat, Allahu Akbar, his salat. It was amazing, it was incredible. 10 out of 10 for his salat. يأتي بصلات. وزكات. His zakat, 10 out of 10. وصيام. 10 out of 10. Worship, he's passed. But that's why he's here. He's passed to salat because of his worship. Then, al-hadith says, يأتي وقد شتم هذا. But however, he's cursed such a person. وَقَذَفَ هَذَا, and he slandered such a person. وَأَكَلَ مَالَ هَذَا, and he's shortchanged this person. He stole him in his business. وَضَرَبَ هَذَا, and he struck and he hit this person oppressively. وَسَفَكَ دَمَ هَذَا, and he spilled the blood of this person oppressively. So what happens? فَيُعْطَى هَذَا مِنْ حَسَنَاتِهِ, the people around, Allah, give us. Give us hasanat. We don't want your dollars anymore. Today we work with hasanat. Give us. So he gives, and he gives, and he gives. فَإِنْ فَنِيَتْ حَسَنَاتُهُ. Allahu Akbar. The word subhanallah is enough in the weight as the mountain of Uhud. Yani how much hasanat? All his hasanat are gone. What happened to this person? What life did he live? What kind of bad manners did he have? Every single hasanah is cleared, bankrupt, finished. And still the people want rights from him. So what happens? The person says, Anna, give me hasanat. He says, Wallah, I don't have, bankrupt. Tayyib, look, this sayyah was going to lead me to Jahannam. Here, take it. And take my sayyah. And take my sayyah. Thumma turihat alayhi faturiha fil nar. The sayyahat, the sins of people, would begin to accumulate on him. And then the hadith says, Thumma turihat fil nar. He is thrown in Jahannam, wal-iyadhu billah. All these hasanat, the long nights in salat, wal-qiyam, wa-ramadan. So all of this is gone because of bad manners. Unacceptable in Islam, bad manners. Change your manners. Change your attitude towards the people. Islam, half of it is manners. Well, manners comes before your worship. And manners is what's going to keep your worship steadfast and firm. My brothers in Islam, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once in Mecca, walking past a sahabi, Abu Mas'ud, not Ibn Mas'ud, Abu Mas'ud al-Ansari radiallahu anhu. And he was lashing, he was beating a slave of his. Now this companion, obviously, he's not oppressing the slave. There must be a good reason for why he's giving him a good beating. But anyway, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw Abu Mas'ud. And he said, I'lam Aba Mas'ud, anna Allaha aqdaru minka ala hadha al-ghulam. Oh Abu Mas'ud, he said to him, oh Abu Mas'ud, make sure and be aware that Allah is more capable upon you than you have upon this servant and upon this slave. Allah Azza wa Jalla is capable. If you are able to oppress others, if you are able to oppress the wife, if you are able to neglect the rights of the children and oppress them, Allah is capable to do whatever He wants with you. So Abu Mas'ud, he was terrified and he freed the slave. He didn't even say, Ya Rasulullah, wait, let me explain to you this story. And I'm beating him because 1, 2, 3. He didn't even say that. No matter what the boy did, it doesn't give you the right to show bad manners to people. So Abu Mas'ud, he said, أَعْتَقْتُهُ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ, I free him for the sake of Allah. خلاص, I have nothing to do with him. And then there's a narration that says that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to him, أما لو لم تفعل للفحتك النار. Or in another narration, لمستك النار. If you did not free him, you would have been burnt by the fire. Allahu Akbar, bad manners would have led to Abu Mas'ud being burnt in the fire. Bad manners, never justify your bad manners. Never justify it. The Muslim is always a degree above, and he always carries his responsibility, and he always carries good manners with him. Well, subhanallah, yani I end with this one last final passage in the Quran. In Surah An-Nahl, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَأَوْفُوا بِعَهْدِ اللَّهِ إِذَا عَهَدْتُمْ وَلَا تَنْقُضُوا الْأَيْمَانَ بَعْدَ تَوْكِيدِهَا وَقَدْ جَعَلْتُمُ اللَّهَ عَلَيْكُمْ كَفِيلًا إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُ مَا تَفْعَلُونَ. Allah Azza wa Jal, he says, fulfill the covenant of Allah Azza wa Jal when you have taken it. Yani when you've given a word to someone, then uphold your word. Don't break your promise. Don't break your word. How do you do that? And the ayah says, وَقَدْ جَعَلْتُمُ اللَّهَ عَلَيْكُمْ كَفِيلًا. And you're the one that made Allah a witness over your word. You say, wallahi, I'm going to deliver such and such service on such and such day, and it'll cost you such and such. And then you neglect your word, and you overturn it, and you don't give, and you don't care as well. Then why did you make Allah Azza wa Jalla as a witness over your case? And you said, wallah, and you took an agreement and a covenant, and you shook hands on it. Allah Azza wa Jalla, he says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُ مَا تَفْعَلُونَ. And at the end of the ayat, Allah Azza wa Jalla, he says, look at the seriousness of it. وَلَا تَتَّخِذُوا أَيْمَانَكُمْ دَخَلًا بَيْنَكُمْ. Do not take the oaths and the covenants between each other as دَخَلًا يعني خِدْعَةً بَيْنَكُمْ. Don't use the oath to deceive and cheat each other. Don't use Allah's name to your advantage. That's bad manners with Allah and bad manners with the people. Because if you do that, you know what happens? Shuf the ayat, how serious they get. وَلَا تَتَّخِذُوا أَيْمَانَكُمْ دَخَلًا بَيْنَكُمْ. What's the result? فَتَزِلَّ قَدَمٌ بَعْدَ ثُبُوتِهَا. People would be misled from Islam. تَزِلَّ قَدَمٌ, meaning a foot, a person. He was about to come into Islam. He saw the goodness of an Islam. Because of your bad dealings, because you violated your own oath, what happened? تَزِلْ, he will slip and he will go away. فَتَزِلَّ قَدَمٌ, one person. Then Allah Azza wa Jalla is telling us, if one person was misled because of your bad deeds, that's a disaster and a calamity. How are you going to face Allah Azza wa Jalla on the day of judgment, knowing that one person lost his deen, lost his Islam and his righteousness because of your bad manners? Not only there, two more parts for the ayah. وَتَذُوقُ السُّوءَ بِمَا صَدَدْتُمْ عَن سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. And because you did that, because of bad manners, you will taste the evil of the punishment. You will taste the punishment because you led people from the deen of Allah. Allahu Akbar. You might argue and you might say that, and I love Islam. I love Islam. I love as-salat, wallah. Allah Azza wa Jalla is telling you that if you have bad manners, you're actually turning people away from al-Islam. وَتَذُوقُ السُّوءَ بِمَا صَدَدْتُمْ عَن سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. You will taste the punishment in this life because you misled people from Islam. وَلَكُمْ عَذَابٌ عَظِيمٌ. And in the hereafter, there is a serious tormentful punishment that will come to such people. My brothers in Islam, rectify the character before it's too late, and solve your issues and your problems with people before it's too late, and give up whatever problem you have in your life for the sake of Allah, so that you can be closer to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the day of judgment. As he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَقْرَبُكُم مِّنِّي مَنْزِلَةً يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَحَاسِنُكُم أَخْلَاقًا. That the people that are close to me on the day of judgment are those who had good manners. And this hadith, in its opposite meaning, it's also true. Those who are far away from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the day of judgment are those with bad manners. Allahumma hassin akhlaqana wa khuluqana ya rabbal alameen. Aqulu qawli hatha wa astaghfirullaha li walakum fastaghfiruhu innahu huwa al-ghafurur rahim. Alhamdulillahi wahdah, as-salatu was-salamu ala man la nabiyya ba'dahu wa ba'd. Hatha wa sallu wa sallimu rahimakumullah ala khayril bariyah وأزكى البشرية محمد بن عبد الله صاحب الحوض والشفاعة. فقد أمركم الله تعالى بأمر بدأ فيه بنفسه وثنى بملائكته المسبحة بقدسه وأيها بكم أيها المؤمنون. فقال عز من قائل إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله العظيم الجليل يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون